yeah, rocking your heart right out into its own reality. You got the Coyote Medicine Show, only on the Hazy Radio Network, baby. Old Grandpa Coyote and Okie Love here helping you guys take flight, rock your heart out, man. Get it just right. Oh, babies, I tell you what, I feel like I just took flight. I'm all out of breath. Man, I tell you, it felt good to be boogieing. To finally get a little movement in these old bones this morning. I hope I got yours shaking and baking, too. And if I don't, just give me a few minutes, baby. We ain't done yet, babies. We just barely begun. 2 hours and 10 minutes into it, babies. We're just starting to warm up. You got to hang on, because we're just starting to sing our song, baby. And it's coming on strong, ain't it? Oh, I hope so. Here's a salute to you, babies, with my old MJ mug, babies. Ooh, get yours over at the Coyote Club. And thanks for being, oh, babies, a full-time member of this Coyote Club. Wow, I got to learn how to sip my coffee a little less strongly, man. Put too much whiskey in that one. Wow. Whew. Near took my breath away. Don't worry, kids. I'm slowing down on the alcohol. I don't drink more than, you know, a keg or two a day of that stuff. That's all, you know. And it just kind of flows through me. And no, I'm kidding, guys. See, I have a little sip here and there. You bet. But not this morning. I should. Baby, somebody bring me over a little bit of honey whiskey and spike my coffee. I need a little woom woom to go with a zoom zoom this morning, okay? Yes, indeedy. I just, you know, hopefully somebody out there in the Vibe Tribe will hear my vibe and bring me in. I feel the divine presence now, baby. Whiskey's on its way. Don't worry. Grandpa's going to be loose for you today. Ooh, babies, I don't know if I can take it, though. I'm getting, you know, kind of old, you know, and a little bit worn around the edges, man. I tell you, it's like, wow, talk about one foot in the grave and another on a banana peel. Oh, I'm so scared, man. You know, it could be the end at any moment. So I just have to grab all the gusto I can right here in the gusto moment that we can get it. Right, kid? That's what Okie says. He says, take it while you can because it ain't going to last forever, babies. Grab and go quickly, so get on down to 7-Eleven, experience some heaven. Oh, darlings, are we having fun this morning? Are we starting to get it on? Are we letting the sun shine in today? Are we coming together in that united way, united in the sunlight of our heart, babies? Oh, darling, yes, we are. Would you like to fly my beautiful balloon, babies? I got a real cool one going on today, I think. Kind of like living in a bubble, ain't it? When you think about the perspective in which we live, the perspective of the whole person, the whole being, the whole physical presence of life that you comprise yourself into, man. And it's not just this tiny little carcass that exists at the center of that energy field we call yourself, man. See, that's what we are. It's energy, divine energy in motion. We personify this particular presence because it's cool and that's what we want to be right now. That's why we are where we are and who we are, what we are, and what it's all about, really. You know, see, we incarnate ourselves as we really truthfully want to be in this moment in time, whatever that is. Sick or well or beautiful or dark and mean or whatever it is, that's what we want to be right now. Else we wouldn't be it, see? The moment one realizes that and realizes they're unhappy where they are, then they change it. You know, it's really simple in this life. It doesn't take much. I don't care who rules over you or what tribe you happen to be a part of or where you are in this earth, man. It can happen for you the moment you wake up and decide, well, screw that, enough of that. And it's really not even a decision. It's a turning point. Because you already see it coming. You know it's there. You already know where your heart is. And you know it's real unhappy where you've been, you know. And so it's going to create for itself a decent dynamic, another way in this life to produce in a way that's far more pleasing to yourself and others, and in fact brings forward the divine harmony oh so sweetly from everybody around you. I mean, it's like y'all work in divinity anyway. You're just perfect synchronicity all the time, man. You see, it changes everything. You might stay in the same place you're at right now. You might be moving on in a hurry because the energy is demanding it, you know. And you're feeling it, and you come to those crux moments. And so Grandpa's just here, you know, helping you pave the way a little bit. You know, I'd rather see you, you know, to have a nice smooth road to ride on and rather than have to take the dusty trail. But, God, I love the dusty trail sometimes, too, so I do meander a bit. Step off the curb every now and then, don't we? And guess what? It doesn't hurt to get hit by a truck, man. You know, it just went right by you and you didn't even feel it, man. You didn't even notice it, you know. Now, something went flying, but it wasn't you. Whoops. Oh, what's that light over my... Oh, geez, I guess I did misstep that one. Oh, baby, it's elegant, really. No matter how you do it, no matter what you fool yourself into, when you start to realize the coyote way, when you wake up to the medicine of the morning, babies, which is coyote, by the way, that's why the coyote's singing in the sunrise, because in the dawn is the revelation of the coyote way, which has been going on here for fucking ever, and we know it too, man, but we're just too damn shy to admit it to ourselves, you know? We think we're so damn smart already in our emptiness, you know, and all that we've done to fulfill that, that we're just too damn clever for the rest of it. Well, babies, we made a little blunder on that one, but not much in one, you know. Here we are, clean waking up to the reality of, like, the ever-loving truth that, yeah, we're hot shit, but, you know, that's just hot shit. It smells pretty awful sometimes, but it can become something rather spectacular. Once it composts itself down a bit and becomes nutrients for the soil once again, and then the little planties rise up, and you've never seen such blossoms, you see. That's the phoenix effect. All of our past becomes the fertilizer from as it decomposes, by the way. And it's exactly doing that. I'm sorry, kids, but it is. It's decomposing around us like it's going out of style. No one has done anything much in the historical sense in this life even matters anymore, hardly, because it's just there and it's going to happen no matter what. The flow is already established now, and there's no stopping it. The river of love flows in one direction and sweeps all along with it because it's the river. You know, I sometimes call it a tidal wave of love. Well, it's that too, because it reformates everything it passes through, including you and me too, you know. And we're in the midst of that happening now. And, you know, inside of ourselves, we experience it here day after day on the Coyote Medicine Show, each day in a little different way and a whole lot sweeter and a whole lot neater. And we just freaking love it, man, because that's what we're here to be, loving, you know. And we're starting to understand what it means to be a love bunny. It don't mean you have to work down at the Playboy Club, though. That's kind of classy. I don't even think there's any of those left, is there? Maybe in Chicago and L.A., there's diehards there. I'd rather see my bunnies hopping around in the fields out there than I would to go into the city to play with them, you know? Oh, God, there's a story for you. One time, you know, I was an aspiring writer when I was a younger dude, you know, and I thought, you know, that was some kind of career or something. I didn't really quite get it yet, you know. So I was like up there to Playboy Club one time when I was kind of stuck in Chicago for a few days. I just put on my duds and called the chick up that was the head honcho editor kind of thing and just said, hey, I'm coming up to see you, baby. And, you know, are you got an opening there? And she said, sure, man. I couldn't believe it. So I went up there, man, and partied down with this chick a little bit. She thought I was some kind of country hick from the sticks that couldn't write his way out of a garbage can, but you know, she was very entertained by my presence and forgave me for being a, you know, a commoner, and even showed me to the door and gave me a little hug and said thank you. You know, I was like, wow. Now that was kind of cool and scholarly of her, man, I thought. Anyway, you know, I didn't feel the rejection in it at all. One little damn bit, you know. That stupid little, I mean, oh, the gracious and wonderful chick that she was. You know? I think I was trying to sell her this far out piece. Oh yeah, what was that one? Oh God. Oh yeah, Nookie Nookie, Little Star. One of the finer pieces of my younger days. It was a short story of about 1,500 words, or maybe it's a little more than that. Hell, I don't remember, but ooh-wee, it was a mystical experience, and then some, as you could well imagine. You know, I think it's got burned in the fires of hell by now, so there's only my memory of it, but, and a few others that got to read it here and there along the way. 'Cause I never did sell that one, man. I just kept that one in the pile somehow. You know, it's like, well, you know, after a while I started realizing the joke in all of that, you know, the writer thing and all that, you know, the image thing of all, you know, and the trying to pigeonhole you off and all that stuff. But, you know, so I just didn't take the writing thing as seriously as I once did when I was younger, you know. And I just let it happen when it happened, you know. And God, you know, since I quit pushing like that, guess what? I've written columns for newspapers, weekly columns for newspapers, and what else? Just done all kinds of stuff, you know, in that area, but I just didn't make a big deal out of it. I just went and did it. Finally published a book too, you know, the Atomic Bum. You know, and while it's kind of wear dated, I'm still awful pleased with that little gem, you know. I gotta remember, you guys remind me, I gotta send a copy to that library in that sweet little town where I grew up over there in Utah, man. One of these days, they've got to have a couple of personally signed copies of The Atomic Bum there at the Springville Library. Springville, Utah. Yeah, that's where I sprouted up as a sproutling this lifetime, man. And although I was actually born over in Spanish Fork because they had a hospital there, and Springville didn't, you know, et cetera, et cetera. But there I was, man. You know, I made a joke out of it for a long time about Santa Claus, Arizona, because I always told people I was born looking like Santa Claus, that probably I was Santa Claus, you know, ho, ho, ho. Just had a little different bag of goodies to deliver than anyone ever suspected. So, you know, it kind of came in rather strangely, as it always does, you know what I mean? Disguises are everywhere. How else you gonna sneak in good energies into this mother trucking reality without you disguise it a bit, you know? And I mean, you gotta keep the innocence hidden pretty hard, 'cause they can sniff it out. Speaking about the way things used to be kind of operated here on that one-dimensional way, you know, where it was just them and us, you know, that was kind of a fun game to play. It really was. But, you know, it got kind of hairy at different points and shit, you know, and it's definitely had its day, that us and them thing, you know. But shoot, where is Pink Floyd when I need him? I mean, it's that kind of shit is out the window, you know. Today it's like liberation for all of humanity, and that's from the very concept of there being any opposition. Because as you begin to realize the unity in yourself, you start to see it in the fields around you, man. You start to see all the flowers blossoming right along with you. It's that time of the season. Turn, turn, turn. It's here at last. It's a whole different world than what we've been, than the shithole we've been living in. And God dang it, I hate to say that, but it is a shithole. I mean, I love each and every one, even I love all the moments I ever lived and all the beings I ever encountered, see? So when I say shithole, what I mean is it's just been stinky old life. We've had, it's been gritty, despite all the goodness that's been going on in it. See, that's what more than offset the shithole and ultimately led to its breaking down to the compost from which the whole new reality arises, you know. And it's happening right inside of us right now. All them stinky parts of ourselves are like sizzling down in the light of the sunrise inside. You see, we're just burning all that shit away, man, and coming back to our true reality. And I know you've never heard it described like this. Well, I don't give a flying truck. Thought I was gonna say something else, didn't you? Well, baby, it's here and now, and it's happening. That's all. Shoot, I mean, let the rest of it go. I don't care what I ever believed or how I ever believed it. I'm just going with the flow, man. I suggest you do the same, you know, because it's like it's nullifying even the need for belief, let alone the need for any ritual or anything like that, babies. It's time to give that shit up and just let it go away and get your nose off of my doggone mouth. Oh, gee whiz. See what I mean? He hits buttons all the time. He starts laying down and he's got to put his head down on my silly old mouth. Almost put us off the air here, didn't you, buddy? Oh, it's comical to live with a little four-legged all the time, man, especially a rascally old. Boy, this guy is so like me, man. He can be just as grumpy too, boy, I tell you. You know, but oh, 99% of the time he's nothing but love, man. And the 1% I can deal with, because that's what I have to deal with him myself. We're fixing it, ain't we, buddy? Yeah, we're getting around the corner. See, he's like a little old for a young dog like he is. I'm a little aged for my 22 years. You know what I mean? We've been well seasoned, man. We're seasoned veterans, both of us, of the trenches of love and the warfare that goes on there. That's why we're such high advocates for more peaceful means these days, man. Enough of the old, it's liberation, man. Enough of that old bullshit. I hate you because you got in my way. You broke my heart, et cetera, et cetera. You stole all my money, et cetera, et cetera. People have been such fiends, you know, and dirty ones at that, you know, and so deceptive, especially. It seems like it's gotten to be crueler and crueler as, you know, this lifetime of mine has gone along. I'm one level in one way, but I see all of that kind of starting to mellow out now. I see suddenly like a shift in the way we do things big time here. You know what I mean? Things like Morgan Stanley and that, you know, all of Wall Street, they've had their day. They're done. They're over with. This is history now. And we can write about it and, well, fuck that. We'll just go liberate ourselves and set those people free right along with the rest of us. And it's all okay. It's all good. We don't have to worry about the old score anymore, you know. That was a state of complete denial. To live with the idea that you're a victim of anything or that anybody could pull a fast one on you in any way. That's what they were there to show you. You know, that's total deception. You are the all-powerful sitting heart of the ruling heart of the entirety of creation. Do you think you have to take shit from anybody? Do you think you can instantly change a situation and make it feel better? And make it go your way, so-called, so everybody's happy. You see? This is how we legalize everything. It ain't just marijuana. Though she's sweet, she sure deserves to be respected and legitimized all across this earth. Because that's the divine energy of love, once again, in plant form, revealing herself to you, man. You know, you guys are just too damn silly to see it. Let the brainwashers and the bullshitters lie to you and teach you that it's something else. And even when you do indulge, you have these overwhelming feelings and blah, blah, blah. When instead, it just wants to take you by the hand and lead you into the promised land. It's a softening agent, a way to get past the hard edges that you've created for yourself in this life. All them little boxes you live in, all them restrictions, all them lines you've drawn, you see? You see what I mean about beliefs? They're getting in your way now, so now just let them go. I mean, just admit inside that, you know, the heart is the all-knowing, and whatever it shows you, that's what is. I mean, what you're living, that's your reality. You don't have to believe it. You just got to live it. You just got to be present in it, fully present, you see? When you're fully conscious, you expand into all levels of your presence, which is everything that surrounds you, too. You see, as I said before, you can't contain this kind of energy inside of just a physical presence. It's surrounded by a crystalline energy, which is the field of love in which we radiate this little body into being. And it's light, baby. It's all light. And then, you know, that radiant little diamond-shaped thing, that creates the sphere of energy around us that comprises our whole person, you know, which is basically the sphere that's joined at all the poles of those, that kind of triangulated, pyramidic. It's like two pyramids joined at the butt, you know, and they're right together. So there really is just one. And it's like, right at the center of it is the heart of it, of course, and that's where we exist as a physical presence. And see that shape, you know, multiplies itself into smaller things and smaller levels and into larger levels, you know. I mean, each energy field is a replication of that one, you see. So it's spherical in its representation energetically, but the thing that holds it together is the crystalline energy of love, the pure love, the light, the heart, the truth in that heart, the real way that human beings are, you see. You see what I mean? This is what I mean by being all powerful. It's not like you sit at the throne at the center of the universe, but in a sense you do. You know, and due honor and respect is owed you greatly these days. You know, in this reality, you know, it really is. It's like it's time for the truthful presence of your heart to be known in this reality. And that doesn't mean you got to go out there and get naked in public. That means you already are inside. You bear the energy of that heart. You let it come forward. You release it. You stop living in those depressed attitudes and realize the gratitudes that you already have. See, gratitude's not something you give yourself, it's something you recognize. You recognize how grateful you are for every moment that you live, no matter how trying it might have been or be or whatever, or how blessed. Yes. Because these are the blessed times. These are the times we get to bless ourselves and bring forward the highest quality of ourself by uniting all the energies within ourselves. So, of course, what does that do? It does the rest of it to reality, too. You know? And I know there's a little grief in giving it up and letting it go, because we sure had a ripe old time here. You know, despite the shithole that we created. I mean, look around you. This is paradise. You know, the lives we were living, the only reason they had this shithole nature is because we let people think we had to live in fear of them and of death and of danger and things like that. That we weren't the all-powerful, we weren't the all-knowing. In fact, we were as far opposite as that you could get. Again, we were a glittery little worm on life's butt, you know, a tiny one too. That's perspective. But because we were glittery little shiny things, well, guess what? We can admit it to ourselves now, you know, and stop letting them bullshit us into being powerless, you know. I mean, you don't deal with it in the direct way, you know, the three-dimensional way. You take care of that as you will. You just let the flow take you there. The reality is what you create in the paradise realm, let's say, where your heart's united with creation. And so its attitude is what creates around you in that field of influence in which you live. Your whole person, in other words. See, you live inside of creation. You are creation. And creation lives inside of you as a result, right there at the center of all that pyramidic energy. I know it's kind of a broad vision, but it's kind of like real, too. You know, this is a way to experience yourself as a whole presence, a whole person. See, they've tried to get you to see it as fractured, as having a male and female side, as being joined in some place other than the center. And it didn't quite work right. It never fit together right, you see, because they never put them together. They always kept them apart. No matter how they displayed them, they just never put those two pyramids together. So there was all this polarity and nonsense involved with that, you see. It gets kind of deep and it gets kind of wide, but it's a rocking reality when you start to live it and see it. And see, that's just another way of experiencing. It's one level of it. In a sense, that's a spaceship that we live in. The spaceship love, each and every one of us, besides me sitting in this old dugout in the side of the mountain up here at the high, high altitudes of Colorado, man. You should be here sometime. Maybe this June would be a good time to plan a little visit out here. Maybe, you know, around the solstice time would be a good time to come and hang out and party down with the locals and let's see what's happening. You know, we're not planning any formal get-together or gathering, you know. We're letting it plan itself if it wants to, you know. And just inviting folks, come on over around solstice and let's party, man. You know, Crestone's a fun place to be in. It's 1,000,000 miles from anywhere else. Well, relatively, you know, it's way out here in the middle of nowhere, you know. So it takes a bit of oomph to get here, you know. You might have to drive over a mountain pass or two, but gosh. If you could see what we live and experience every day, let alone the energy, the powerful energy of it, well, you'd have been here yesterday, let alone tomorrow. You know what I mean? Let alone June, mid-June. Well, that's, what is that? About around the 21st, yeah. So the solstice, around June 21, yeah. This year would be a good time to come and hang out and party with the locals, you know, and make friends with everybody. And let's have a good time. And maybe a few of us will get together and create a little energy circle and change the way things are. Why not, man? You know, we can dream it together as a unified heart. If there's a dozen or more, I think that's, well, really, if there's one, that's enough. But it'd be fun to gather with the whole family and read that made it in the first place and then just recreate it all. That'd be a kick in the ass. Especially, you know, if we could do it in the company of a whole bunch of friends while we're rocking and partying along some little creekside or downtown Crestone or wherever we happen to be, you know, when it finally winds itself around. You know, I've done all this planning and shit before for these gatherings, and guess what? It just does what it wants to and goes where it wants to be anyway. So this time I'm just saying, come on over and let's party, man, you know. Let's play. I'll make myself available, obviously, you know, and we'll just go with the flow and let it take us where it needs to be, you know. I'm just, you know, just like any gathering, it's probably going to involve some camping out and stuff, so be ready for that. But, and remember, it's high altitude, so it can be a little chilly on summer nights here, you know, it can. So you want to come prepared for that, and you know, it can even be cold in the daytime in the summer because it is high altitude, so just be ready for some changes in the weather and be willing to hang out outdoors for a bit. And come on over here to Crestone. Let's invade the place with love, man, and permeate the atmosphere with a total radiance of uniform, single-hearted love, man, the kind that lives in everyone. But the more and more hearts that are united with it, the better and better it is for everybody else. So that's the reason why we'd even propose such a gathering, you know. So do whatever it takes to get here if you feel like it. Follow the heart. Follow the flow. If it says, baby, baby, I want to go, well, you better get out of the way and let it take you there, huh? If it says, hell no, I won't go, you look at it and say, why? I mean, what's what? And then you got to deal with those aspects. And, you know, probably there's a reason, you know, and you'll have to find it. But anyway, just do what it intends for you, you know. Just go with the flow, man. Be conscious, you know. Don't just come because you think you're going to get something or something like that. Come because you want to share. You want to be. You want to be with the family. You want to be amongst people that feel familiar to you. Even though you maybe have been unfamiliar for a few thousand years now, you still know one another from the journeys of the past, let alone the present moment, where you start to recognize your energetic connections, your family connections that are resonating harmonies, vibrations as they're called. Similar to the music that we play here on the Coyote Medicine Show. Yes, indeed, the tunage that is so large. Yes, indeed, babies. The expansive love comes to us in many, many different ways and through many, many different plays, too. So just be ready for them all, man. Take it as it comes. But this summer, let's take it on the run, shall we, babies? Let's fulfill the heart once and forever. Why not? You know, we don't have to live in that sappy old place anymore, do we?